Hello, I'm Simon Whistler. You're watching the Today I Found Our YouTube channel, and in the video today, we're looking at what Neil Armstrong really said when he stepped foot on the moon. When Neil Armstrong set his left boot on the surface of the moon on July the 21st, 1969, becoming the first person to ever walk on the moon, he then spoke some of the most famous words in the history of mankind.
One small step for man.
So true, so brilliant, so inspirational, yet so contradicting. The word man and mankind are used synonymously, meaning that the oh-so-famous quote, quite simply put, was, "That's one small step for man, one giant leap for man." Huh? A one-lettered, indefinite article is all it would take to turn this quote into the inspirational words our brains all process when we hear them. That article is A. One small step for a man, one giant leap for mankind. That is how most people interpret his words, and according to Neil Armstrong, those are the words he intended to speak. NASA's official transcript of the quote still shows the A in parentheses. That's one small step for a man, one giant leap for mankind. This is because the A is not audible in the broadcast. For years, both NASA and Armstrong insisted that static had obscured the A. Armstrong himself stated that he would never make such a mistake, omitting such an important part, but after listening to recordings of his quote, he finally conceded that it's possible that he may not have said the A. When he admitted this, he stated, "I would hope that history would grant me leeway for dropping the syllable and understanding that it was certainly intended, even if it was not said, although it might actually have been." An Australia-based computer programmer named Patter Shun Ford conducted a digital audio analysis to support Armstrong's claim that he did say A and concluded that he did, in fact, say A man, but the A was inaudible due to technical limitations of the time. However, linguists David Beaver and Mark Lieberman wrote their own digital audio analysis of the infamous quote on Language Log blog and concluded that the acoustic evidence seems to be against Ford's theory. But that's not the end of the story. Support for Armstrong has been found in a team of researchers from Michigan State University and Ohio State University who have concluded that Armstrong did indeed speak the words he claims to have spoken, but static or technological limitations are not to blame for its apparent omission. According to them, Armstrong's Ohioan accent is to blame. According to a Michigan State University specialist in communicative sciences, assistant professor Laura Diller, because of the dialect of his hometown, if Neil Armstrong did voice the word A, it was short and fully acoustically blended with the preceding word for. The Acoustical Society of America's article on this topic states that Dilly and her colleagues, who include MSU linguist Melissa Bass-Burke and OSU psychologist Mark Pitt, thought they might be able to figure out what Armstrong said with a statistical analysis of the duration of the R sound as spoken by native Central Ohioans saying for and for A in natural conversation. They used a collection of recordings of conversational speech from 40 people raised in Columbus, Ohio, near Armstrong's native town of Wapakoneta. Within this body of recordings, they found 191 cases of 4A. They matched each of these to an instance of 4 as said by the same speaker and compared the relative duration. They also examined the duration of Armstrong's 4A from the lunar transmission. The researchers found a large overlay between the relative duration of the R sound in 4 and 4A using the Ohio speech data. The duration of the fr in Armstrong's recording was 0.127 seconds, which falls into the middle of this overlap, though it is a slightly better match for an A less 4. In other words, the researchers conclude the lunar landing quote is highly compatible with either possible interpretation, though it is probably slightly more likely to be perceived as 4, regardless of what Armstrong actually said. Dilly says there may have been a perfect storm of conditions for the word A to have been spoken but not heard. So I really hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, please do give us a like below and don't forget to subscribe. Also, why not share it with a friend? There are tons of social sharing tabs below this video, so check those out. Check out those other two videos we're linking to over on the right, and thanks for watching.